In my experience, celeriac is a bit of a polarizing vegetable. It has a unique flavor that not all people are fond of. I happen to like it, so it was just a matter of time before I tried fermenting it. The recipe, as usual, can be found on the blog. I have a large celeriac here. I'll start by peeling it. This may sometimes be slightly difficult, especially around the roots on the bottom. A paring knife is needed. I cut a slice from the middle. I'll need it later. I slice the rest into manageable chunks and shred them using a grater. I sprinkle salt over the shredded celeriac. I have 4 chunks, so I use about a quarter of the prepared amount of salt. I give everything a rough mix to more evenly distribute the salt. The next step is to transfer the shredded celeriac into a jar. I don't wait for the salt to draw moisture out of the shreds, it'll do it in the jar. I pack the shreds as tightly as possible. Once the jar is full enough, I take the slice I saved at the beginning and use it to hold the shreds underneath. I need to trim it a bit. It's in, and I can see that the salt has already done its job. The celeriac is completely submerged in its own juices. This will make sure no mold can form on the floating bits. I like to add a fermentation weight, but the slice on top would have probably been enough. Then I close the jar and I'm done. I'll keep the jar at room temperature for a few days. The lactic acid bacteria present in the celeriac will gradually colonize the brine and convert the naturally occurring sugars into lactic acid. This fermentation isn't too vigorous, so I let the jar sit for at least 5 days to a week before opening it. The bubbles on top of the brine indicate that it's still fermenting. Thank you. The aroma is exactly as can be expected. Slightly sour, but the unique celeriac smell is very clearly present. The taste is very similar. There's no residual sweetness since the celeriac was low in sugars to begin with. Instead, there's a subdued lactic sourness, and of course, the celeriac flavor. I think this is a great side dish and a sandwich relish. Yum.